looks like grinding holes kind of, but I'm not gonna say it is. Look back in there, wow. Okay, I'm gonna do this for you guys because we're already over here. Oh, thought that was a snake. Holy smoke. Well, there's something weird right there. Let's get our hands and knees crawl in here. Look at this thing. Wow. There's some new graffiti. Look at that. People have been up in here. Whew. Look at that. My God. Is that crazy or what? I don't know if that's the easy way through. Oh man. Wow, pretty incredible. Wouldn't want to do that again. Oh man. Well, I think it's time that, look at that. I think it's time to get out of here. Work our way back. We still got a lot of walking to do. It's time to definitely head back. Whew. I went back in the hole for you guys right there. Well, saw some old, you know, people have been going back there swimming though. Just goes to show you, people are everywhere. I don't like that. Don't look like a whole lot, but it kind of is. Got one more steep section and then I think it's pretty good. That wasn't bad. Don't rest too easy, too quick. Whew. I still got some downhills to do, so it's time to head that way because you don't want to be on this, any of this loose stuff and not have your faculties about you at all. You want to make sure that... Well, there's the truck. I'm taking a little break. You know, I didn't used to rest at all, which just seems kind of stupid, I know, but I didn't used to. Now I'm like, okay, I shouldn't have to rest again going down there, but, you know, before I take that little section right there, not difficult, but, you know, if you're mentally not ready or you're tired, man, you don't watch where you step. You just know you're not agile. You know, you take a chance on falling down out here, man, you get jacked up. And we are like 22 miles from quartzite, and we're off the road, and we're another, I don't know, 30 from Yuma, 40. You're out of here. So there's no reason to hurry, and there's no reason to make stupid decisions when you're out here. Just take your time, gather your thoughts, and... Now that looks like a big ass mortar. Now that looks like a big mortar right there. Normally I can tell these, but today I haven't seen a lot, but I know they're here. I just haven't found them. You know, that definitely would have been considered sacred right there. To have water out here in the desert, how incredible would that have been? You know, I searched all over for these little mortars, and then John had seen them before. And here they are, right here. A lot of these little mortars right here. Looks like even this rock here. Yeah, maybe not. But there's the small ones right here. A lot of stuff going on in this area. Those are hard to see, though. Semi-filled up. But here's some more right in here. It's amazing how square they got them. I mean, when I say square, how smooth the circles are. And they were grinding stuff all the way through here. Look at that. Now, see, I missed them on the way up, and I missed them on the way down. You know, what's amazing is you walk right by this stuff, and you don't even know. You know, you miss it. Even today, as much as we have looked at this stuff and found stuff, you can walk right by these, and here's the small kitchen right here. And you know, we walked all the way up that hill looking for stuff. Look how deep this one is. It just amazes me. Because I can still imagine, like, you know, people down here working these holes, you know, grinding stuff that they found all day long. So it just goes to show you, you know, here's the trail right here. I walked right by it and missed them, right? Right here. Isn't that crazy? Missed the little ones up there. Well, I'll tell you what, for the second stop on this trip, what an incredible place this was, just to see water here, because you know it's got animals, and you know it had people. And how crazy is that? This stop was, the second stop was an awesome stop. I'm telling you what, it was really incredible on this journey that we're taking. This place is one of the most beautiful places I think I've ever been. Look at that valley. My God, look at that. Isn't that incredible? I'm gonna take a look over here. There's some petroglyphs. Now, they could be graffiti of some type. I don't know how old they are, but you can definitely tell there's some writing on those rocks. So we're gonna take a walk through here and see if, I can't see what's over there. I don't know why they would have chosen that point. But you know, they worked a lot more down on this end of the creek. Looks like modern. Definitely looks modern. Then there looks like maybe some ancient stuff to the left. EW. Looks like 1920 something. But all that, that's ancient stuff right there. Those are ancient marks right there, grooves right there, for sure. It's too bad that they jacked this rock up with that, because that was definitely some type of cool stuff at one time. It's kind of funny, this mark, it's had to almost been a rock where they were telling everybody else down there, you know, who and what they were, because you can see the grooves over here. You see there's a lot of stuff there. I might want to get my camera out, take a picture, and see if we can't get that de-stretched. Let's see if we can't get it. Been some pretty good petroglyphs, if they wouldn't have beat them to death, but they look pretty old, like a calendar of some type also. You know, we're gonna take the GPS. We have the coordinates, and I'm gonna follow it right through here. Now, I got a weird feeling it's gonna take us right back to where I was at, but I'll go down here a little ways and at least see. I really like this GPS because it's really dead accurate. Look how it's just floating us where we wanna go. So if you've got coordinates in, you know, it's walking right back up here, which is cool. I just want to see it. So what we're really doing more than anything is, you know, the GPS I've got, this John's old one, Yeah, it's going to take us right back up to where we were, but look how cool that is. Dead center, right to that point. That's pretty cool. It just shows to show you how cool it is when you've got the right equipment. So yeah, that was going to take us right back there, but boy, it was dead accurate. You know, I'm on my way to a location that they're telling me that is just unbelievable, and it's only about 400 feet off the area where we parked, so it's not very far walking. And I'm told this is just a very special, spectacular place. Man, look where we're at today. Look at this. See a lot of trails going up even that way. There's a rock over there. Might want to take a look at that and all the stuff that's within this little area right here. This definitely had to have been a special location, and you're wondering why they chose this specific area. And you know, I'm not really sure, but we're going to find out. It's supposed to be a magnificent kitchen up here, so we'll see if there is or not. But I can see petroglyphs up there on the top of that rock up there. I can see them up there. So what we're going to do is take a walk down here and man, this place is beautiful. Look at that scenery right there. That's absolutely unbelievable. It don't even look real. This whole area does not even look real. And we know it is. So we're going to take a walk up here. Oh, look at these holes. Oh my gosh. Look at this. Man, this was a serious kitchen up here. Look at that grinding holes. Wow. They're all over. Man, look how deep they are. Wow. I'm telling you what, I'm just gonna take a seat right here. Take a look at these. This is really an incredible location. First off, I want you to look out here and see what you see. Look at that beautiful valley right here. So this little outcropping right here, look at all these mortars that are in here in this kitchen. My gosh. Really a spectacular place. Now, I don't know if there's any writings on these walls at all. This material didn't make the best material to draw, paint. I'm gonna guess right there that's definitely petroglyph here. But it's hard to say these grooves of red come through here. I'm trying to see if they see anything else. That definitely looks like something right there. Doesn't mean it is though. This rock has, what we're going to do though, is we are going to see if we can de-stretch it. See if there is anything there. Walk back a little bit. I don't think I've ever seen the depth of these type of mortars. I mean, and then you have the small grinding right through here. And then you had the deep, deep mortars. You know, they would sit back up in here out of the sun in this area. How cool is this? Man, that's unreal. This is an unreal location right here. Tell you what, let's take a walk around. You can see these rocks are worn out. They would have walked on these rocks. And believe it or not, it does wear the rocks out. You can see it. And another little rock outcropping right here. Look at that area down there. That doesn't even look real. does not look real. You know, when you're back in these locations, it's just, you can't help but think, you know, what was it like to live back then? I mean, the area and the landscape is beautiful. I mean, it's a gorgeous place to be right now. And the amount of greenery means that they're definitely getting rain, even though this is a pretty harsh desert. So the greenery, and there were streams that ran through here all the way, and that kitchen down below was a thing of beauty, unbelievable. I mean, so when you get up here, you can't even, you know, you just look around and you're like, man, why don't you guys enjoy just the peacefulness of this area? This is, man. You know, how unreal is that? I just can't even get over it. It doesn't even look real. That just kills me. How unreal that is out there. How beautiful that really is. I'm going to swing by this kitchen one more time. And there's a petroglyphs on the other side we're going to take a look at real quick. Out of the heat of the sun. Look at this. Was that something back up there that I missed maybe? All kind of grinding holes all over this. How cool is this cliff? That's for sure. As we get over here, pretty hard to decipher some of this stuff. I got this here, right there. You know, when you're looking at an area, man, you look at a trail like this. This is not a hiking trail, and it's not a couple days old. This is an old trail. Now, one of the things you can definitely tell is those rocks have been worn. And again, that didn't happen in a day. Now, the trail splits to here because it looks like a little shelter over here. Nothing there. Now these rocks here were definitely stacked. Does that mean that they're ancient or not? Not really. For sure. I'm really liking this rock here. This would have been a great little outcropping though. You know, I'm going to tell you right now what I think is that absolutely positively this is real. I'm going to tell you I believe it's real because of that little fireplace thing right there, which would have smoked them rocks on the outside. Absolutely. That wouldn't have been there. I would have told you maybe this is not real, but after seeing this, I 100% believe that wall right there is real. You know, you don't always got to kill yourself. How unreal is this area? Pretty damn neat. It is pretty damn neat. Well, if you like this content, subscribe. If you'd like to help us on this journey, you can donate to Patreon. Please hit the notification bell. It's going to let you know when we have videos. And man, this is another adventure from Black Flag. What a great day so far. Unreal adventure. Stop number 3. Unreal. What a cool deal. And I've got John. He's got a shirt on. But earlier, he was acting more like a... He said, this is what the natives and the ancients used to, how they used to travel. And I said, okay.
Is that amazing? Holding the ranch.